hugging the knee, controlling the armpit or the tricep. This is the Heisman position. This is the first stage.
Can you do it real fast, real time, twice, please?
Sure. Questions? Let's go.
Feels like somebody said that, but once I get to the Heisman, there's a few things he can do to resist. He can turn into me. You see what this blocking and using this butterfly hook is for, to move back away, staying on my side. He can try to spin out. He can try to stand up, get my heel off. All right, we have sweeps for each one of these, and transitions from each one of these. The basic one that I like to use is the cleave to get him broken down to a prone position. So once I'm here, I'm going to take my left foot, kick his leg out, stomp my right foot down on the mat. And now my left shin goes right up to my right ankle, and then now my left butterfly hook stays active right across the crease of his butt where his butt meets his hamstring. And now I'm in an outside wedge. My shin is pressing into my foot, stomping my right foot down, pinching my knee to the floor. Now, once I'm in an outside wedge, I'm in a position where I can finish. I'll then slide back, heel hook, hand pressing foot flex, hand pressing foot flex, heel hook combo, or straight ankle lock. All right. Get established the position first, then submit. Because once he's broken down, he has to move his hips back up in the air to be able to do anything. Even before he can roll, he doesn't want to roll from here. He's too flat to have his hips controlled. He'd have to elevate his hips to create some space first. So back him back up. So again, from the Heisman, all I'm going to do is cleave his leg. I'm going to take my left foot right on the front of the knee, and I'm going to make him do the splits, but I'm also going to kind of kick and angle it behind him as I stomp my right foot down. Then I bring my left foot back up to a butterfly hook. My left shin is pressing into my right ankle, hugging the knee, keeping my shoulders stacked, and then sliding back for finish of your choice, whether you're working on the heel hook, straight ankle lock, hand pressing foot flex. Again, this is called the cleave. One more time. Stomp him down. Finish. Again. Hug that knee. Now that left foot comes in front, push, cleaving his leg is out, stomping that right foot down. You want to break him down to this prone position. Left foot flips back over to a butterfly hook, pushing my left knee into my right ankle while hugging the knee, keeping my shoulders stacked, and then I can slide back for my finish. Questions on that one? All right, now we're going to do where they spin out. Why it's important that you hug the knee. All right. so eloquently put earlier, and I couldn't match that eloquence, is
you have to hug the knee.
If you don't hug the knee, they're out.
There's nothing that's going to be able to prevent them from pulling that leg away.
So if you're focusing on the heel hook, you're focusing on the ankle lock, and you're not hugging the knee, you're doing yourself a major disservice. It's unlikely to get out, especially if you have good awareness to begin with. So, and this can even happen when you are hugging the knee if you're not good at it. Once I'm here, I break him down. He's immediately going to pop back up and then spin away. Okay, corkscrew is just going with the torque on his knee. If you go corkscrew against the knee, and that happens. You know what you hear about how dangerous leg locks are in the gym? It's generally not because of the person attacking. It's generally because the person is improperly defending and they went up hurting themselves. Scott's got an incredible amount of leg lock finishes, as does Wally, and tournaments. And they've had some guys go out on stretchers before. And almost to a T, 100%. Man, maybe I'll go maybe 98%. It's because the other guy didn't know what they were doing. You know, reaping the knee, they fall and collapse, or they try to turn in against it, and the knee goes out, or having a heel hook, spinning the wrong way in a heel hook. That's been really good. There's a couple. They've actually broke the same guy's opposite leg because the guy decided to fight the next match and they're in the same division. Wally broke his leg the first match, and then Scott broke his leg the second match. And fought back up. His other leg, so that guy wasn't walking very long. So be cautious when you're defending leg locks. Tap early until you learn and develop a sense of awareness and positional aptitude. Tap early. Even if you're like, man, it doesn't hurt, because it can go from not hurting to injury instantly. Especially if you have flexible legs. So take care, be cautious, tap early until you start developing your sense of awareness and you really trust your training partner. So what we're going to do now is what I refer to as the depth charge, or it's a swim move from the cleat. Once I break him down, I'm stomping my foot on the floor, getting that butterfly hook behind his butt and hugging the knee. Scott, can you get that?
Sure.
Just a stopwatch, just throw it in the office. Left butterfly hook is, again, under the crease of his butt, where his butt meets his hamstring, not his butt crack. Squeezing the knee. He's going to try to lift his hips up off the mat just a little bit, and he's going to start to look away. He's going to roll over his left shoulder. Now, what I'm going to do is use this left butterfly hook as a means to control the speed in which we roll. I'm going to go back a little bit more. So as he starts to turn, I'm going to use that left butterfly hook, hug the knee, swim my arm over the head, all the way through, grab the foot, kick out with the left, step the right over, slide the right foot underneath the knee, stepping under, behind the ankle, right into the knee knot. Okay, this is the depth charge, or the swim move to the knee knot. You have to hug the knee. If you don't hug the knee, he's going to be gone. Cleave. Stomp. Good butterfly hook on the far side. He pops up. He's going to spin away. Hug the knee. Keep your elbow pinched as well. Arm over the head all the way through. Cup the foot on the way over. Use the left leg to clear some space for your right. All the way on your side. So we're ending up the same position we started. We just roll 360 degrees. Right foot slides under the knee. Left leg steps over, slides behind. Stretch right into the knee knot. Finish your choice. But focus on hugging the knee and swimming through. Heisman, cleave the leg, stomp, get that outside wedge, hug the knee. He starts to pop up, use use this butterfly hook to control the speed.
Swim move.
Use the left to elevate. Control the toes, underhook with the right leg, drag it back, right into the knee knot, finish of your choice.
Questions? Alright, you took a question. Well, you can still you can finish in the clamp ledge or the knot. So ideally we want to go to the knot. You can do it without grabbing toes.
You just have to have the reps in. If it can spin faster than you can maintain, you run the risk of losing it. But if you're really hugging the knee, it could be enough. But I wouldn't count on it. Always try to keep that butterfly under pressure control. Alright, let's get a shot. I think it's probably the most important thing in the entire universe.
Yeah.
straighten out. He wants to straighten out and spin. Do not let him straighten that leg. Ready? Hug the knees. Bend this leg with your body. You're kind of sitting up. And your free hand, make sure that leg is knotted up. Stays knotted up. Go! Okay, so if you can control the guy for 20 seconds, 30 seconds, and then eventually get down. Now, you don't, most jiu-jitsu positions, you can't control someone for as long as you want. There's only a few positions left. This is the collar, after a lucky chair, when you're not heading on to the bend, you can stay there all day. There's only a certain, maybe five positions where it's up to you. You can hold them. This one, you're not going to be able to hold them for 30 minutes or 20 minutes. All you need is to be able to control them for a good 10, 15 seconds, and he's done. That's it. It's just like an offensive lineman. If he can block a guy for 4 seconds every play, he's going to pro. Is it 4 or 5 seconds? Something like that. You're not supposed to block a guy for a minute. You can't block him for a minute. We're going to have to cut him. Within a minute, guy always goes past. It's just like that. There's certain positions. You just need to control for a second. You got an overlook, you're going for a triangle, you're controlling that wrist. You don't have to control that wrist for half an hour. If you can control for 3 seconds,